This time on Getaway Moments, monarch butterflies. For years, I've been raising them to photograph them, and I've shared them on my channel many times. Unfortunately, I've been doing something very wrong, tragically wrong, but I'm about to fix that. This year, I finally bought some native milkweed and am raising it myself. The problem is, most of us who live in Florida or on the Gulf Coast of the United States have been buying milkweed from big box stores that is actually the wrong kind of food to feed monarchs. It grows all year round and it never dies back. This is tropical milkweed. And you can see there's a caterpillar on it. This is all tropical milkweed. This is tropical milkweed as well. There's a parasite called OE that lives on it, and if you don't cut it back, it continues to grow on the plants. The monarchs eat the plants, then the parasite makes the monarchs sick. This is a monarch that was probably infected with OE. It usually causes problems with their wings being deformed. So this poor monarch came out of its chrysalis and its wing just didn't unfold and it died. Sometimes you can tell that the chrysalises are infected because they have dark spots. This one actually looks fairly good, but you never know until they open up whether or not it's been infected or not. Usually the monarchs come through about November here in Florida, and this year they really didn't show up. And normally the rule here is if you have any tropical milkweed at all, you ought to cut it down at Thanksgiving. Basically take the food tray away so the monarchs don't stay or stop here past that point. We didn't have any monarchs really come through, and I was busy and I didn't cut my milkweed back. And what's interesting is they showed up in January, which is not when they should show up. Unfortunately, a lot of this milkweed may have had OE on it, and so now I've got caterpillars and monarchs that are probably getting OE from these plants, and I should have cut them back at Thanksgiving. Now this is a bright spot of the story. This is an earth box that I planted with native milkweed seeds back in October, and these plants will be ready for next summer, and all of these will die back in the fall. But hopefully I'll be able to get more seeds off of these plants so I can transform my garden into an entire native milkweed garden. These are milkweed seeds, which would be a great thing if this was native milkweed, but this is the tropical milkweed. So you really don't want these spreading in your garden, or it's just going to spread more of the tropical milkweed. This is the best way to show the difference between the milkweeds. This is tropical milkweed. And it's February and it's still growing and healthy. This is the native milkweed here to Central Florida, and as you can see, it's died back and brown. Now it died back in November, December, and this has grown since then. So this would be a nice healthy plant come April, May, when the monarchs come back through. What you should be growing, what you probably should not be growing. For those of you who have tropical milkweed, you can grow it. It's just you ought to cut it all the way back down to the base at Thanksgiving so that it can't grow this big over winter. It really is a simple idea. Grow the plants that belong where you live, and you'll probably help the monarchs out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your butterfly-loving friends. Thanks for watching.